You are for real in this game. If I'm putting my money down, I'm putting my money on Oklahoma today.
Clemson against a somewhat decent Wake Forest at home. No, I'm sorry, Wake Forest is at home. My apologies. Go ahead.
It's going to be interesting to see how Clemson rebounds from last week. They're given 20 points, and they're a team that after a quarterback injury last week, I don't know that I would definitely put my money on as close as they played with Syracuse. So 20 points in this game does seem like a lot. Normally it probably wouldn't be, but if I'm going to bet this game, I would probably take Wake Forest and take the 20 points.
A game a lot of people are going to be watching, number 13, Kentucky Wildcats against the Texas A&M Aggies. And they're and Texas A&M are at home.
Yeah, you know, it's Jimbo Fisher needs to get things together here and get them together pretty quick. But, you know, Kentucky has been a very fun team to watch so far. I don't think a lot of people were counting on this Kentucky team to be as good as they are. You know, and it shows by the fact that A&M's only given 6 points. I think last year it was almost a 30-point line. So, you know, it's really hard. I mean, I like Kentucky a lot, but you're going into that stadium, that environment, and you're playing against a team that that definitely recruits a lot better than Kentucky does. I would stay away from it just because six doesn't seem like a lot. I'd love to see Kentucky win the game outright, but it's too few points for me to put money on and risk it.
We've been talking with Mo for the VS Sports Show. Let's cap it off with some fun Big Ten action. You got Ohio State at Indiana. Indiana always plays Ohio State good. And at home, I don't know that they have the enough in them to beat Ohio State, but maybe it's a good pick because they can cover the spread.
Well, I've cashed on this game every year for the past 4 or 5 years, and here's why. I only bet the first half because that seems to where Indiana is able to stay close with Ohio State. Usually the end of the third quarter is where things start to fall apart. It's a lower spread than it has been in past years, only 26.5. I would take Indiana. I would take the points, but I would also bet it heavily just in the first half.
An interesting game that I think is going to be good to watch. I like Nebraska. They've had kind of a slow start, but I do think, there again, they may not be able to beat Wisconsin, but I think they also can cover the spread against the Badgers.
Well, what would scare me is they've gotten beat by terrible teams so far this year already. And, you know, Wisconsin as a team looking to get things rolling, trying to take that their side of the conference again this year. It's dropped from 23 where it opened to 17.5. So if you like Nebraska, you only get, if you bet it early, it's something I'd probably like the 17.5. You figure Scott Frost probably turns around sooner or later, but man, they've just been terrible all the way around. But I would probably take Wisconsin and give the points, but it would be one that is close enough that would make me not open my wallet for it.
Final game, Michigan at Maryland, number 15, Michigan. Maryland's at home.
Well, it would have been a matchup with Jim Harbaugh and his former coach, but since J.J. Durkin is suspended, they're probably going to be fired. You know, Michigan's been on a roll these last few weeks. I see that continue today. It's 17.5. The line has not moved since it opened. I would take Michigan and give the points.
Mark from the BS Sports Show, appreciate you joining us today. Where can people find your work and your masterpieces, sir?
On Twitter, at Mo Radio Show.
All right, buddy, you have yourself a good day, and hopefully all your bets pay off, sir.
Thank you, Tom. I appreciate it.
Sure. Mark from the BS Sports Show, joining us, talk a little bit of MLB action, postseason action. And we always like to talk betting with Mo. Mo knows his betting, that's for sure. Thanks to Matthew Embury for breaking down some college football with us. Steve Wilson of Speedway Digest, our official NASCAR contributor, talking Dover, talking new aero kits, talking some NASCAR news with us. And ed-kracz and Rick Riggin joined us for some NFL talk. And so I think we've covered the gamut. My name is tom-marquis, El Presidente. Remember, don't drink and drive. It isn't cool. We'll see you, hopefully, if all goes well and we have puppy dogs and butterflies and all of that good stuff. We'll have Breaking Rank on Wednesday night. My name is tom-marquis, El Presidente. Don't drink and drive. It isn't cool. I'm out of here. Deuces.
Join us next week for The Balance. In the meantime, check us out on Twitter, T-Balance, or Facebook, The Balance, or online at www.thebalanceonline.com.